Often when the topic of jobs lost to automation comes out, you will hear the number 47% bandied about. You may see things like, quote, studies say 47% of jobs will vanish due to automation, unquote. The number comes from one of the very finest and certainly most quoted studies on the topic that came out of Oxford in 2013. The report is 72 pages long, but most of the time what gets referenced online and in the media is a single 10-word phrase, quote, about 47% of total U.S. employment is at risk, unquote. I mean, who needs more than that, right? But the authors, Frey and Osborne, had much more to say on the topic. And towards the end of the report, they had a 400-word description of some of the limitations of their own study's methodology. They state, quote, we make no attempt to estimate how many jobs are actually going to be automated. The actual extent and pace of computerization will depend on several additional factors which we have left unaccounted, unquote. What Frey and Osborne actually claimed was that 47% of the things that we do in our jobs can be automated. Now, that's interesting to be sure, but not particularly surprising. That's pretty much the history of technology and employment. Think of any job from 1990 and reflect on how much it has changed in that time. We expect technology to make us more productive, and it has always done so against the backdrop of full employment. If you're interested in artificial intelligence, visit gigaom.com or check out my new book, The Fourth Age, Smart Robots, Conscious Computers, and the Future of Humanity.